Good morning and welcome to MTV. How are our Olympic students doing? They had hoped to shine in Japan a year ago, but the pandemic broke. Now it's only 2 months before the Olympic Games begin. We are going to talk with water polo star Iris Wolfs and hockey international Marlous Ketels. But first, news. Students all over the Netherlands are protesting against the student loan system. They are against the debts that students accumulate through the system. The protests are organized in 8 cities. Wednesday in Rotterdam, today in Amsterdam, and Friday in Leiden and Nijmegen. In the future, universities may require a test or a vaccination certificate from students. No proof? Then you might not be allowed to be on campus. A law has been passed that makes this measure possible. Recently, students and employees can request a free self-test kit. Our reporter and medical student Ferayet shows you how to do the test properly.
Today we're going to try these self-tests, and I'll take you through the process of how to do it. Once you've opened up the packet, there's a few things you have to do. Make sure you you've blown your nose so it's clean. Make sure you wash your hands with soap. Then you open up the fluid, the tube of fluid, and make sure you keep that in your left or right hand. Then you open up the packet of the swab. Make sure you don't touch the head of the swab, just the stick part, and go into the left side of your nose. It takes about 15 seconds and you have to go in one side about 4 times. Then put the swab in the other side of your nose. Then you take out the swab and put it in the tube of fluid and you whisk around about 10 times in the fluid. Then you take the cap and you put it on the tube. Take out the test strip and make sure that exactly 4 droplets of the fluid come on the test surface. You just have to wait about 15 to 30 minutes before you have the results.
Academic staff of the International Institute of Social Studies want their pension fund ABP to break ties with companies that have ties with the military junta in Myanmar. The academics don't want their pension fund to be linked to them, they write in an open letter. The Erasmus Sport reopens their door. Since yesterday, you can enjoy your workout again in the fitness center or sport halls. Let's take a look how happy the sports fanatics among us with this reopening. Feeling safe and happy, that's how students feel about working out in Erasmus Sport. And the same, of course, goes for our Olympic students. They have to wait for a while, but at the end of July, the Olympic Games in Tokyo will finally start. Two athletes / Earth students are joining us today. Water polo player Iris Wolfs in the studio and hockey player Marlous Ketels digitally. Welcome to you both, and we're starting with you. Iris, what was your first reaction when you heard that the Olympics will proceed this year?
I'm really happy that they're going through this year because it's been just so insecure with quarantine, lockdowns. I'm just happy we can prepare for the games and that there's a starting date.
Yeah, and at the moment you are of course working hard on your training schedule. And we have a little video that will give a good impression of how hard you work. So it is. It looks like you can literally lift me up. And do you train this intensive every day?
Yes, we're training 5 to 6 times a week, and we're doing 3 of these gym sessions and two water sessions a day.
And, yes. And these kind of sessions are needed because you have to be strong to.
Yes, you need a lot of power in the water, and we train our water skills with swimming and doing ball sessions. So yeah. Yes.
And just this week, Japanese doctors and citizens called for the games to be cancelled because COVID-19 is still surging and the hospitals are full. And you are a health law student, so how do you feel about going to Japan in this respect?
Yeah, I think it's really difficult. I hope the Olympic Committee can organize a safe games. And I'm happy that there are no spectators allowed because I think it should be a small organization. But yeah. I'm happy we're going to play sports.
Yeah, yes. And how do you think your Japan trip will look like given the corona measures?
I think it will be quarantined, just hotel or Olympic Village to the pool and back, and that's gonna be it.
Yeah, yes. And you're okay with that?
It's a shame, but I think it's necessary. But I'm just happy we can play the games, and that's it.
Yeah, and what do you expect from your for your team in Tokyo?
I think if it's hard for the water polo players to go to the Olympics to qualify, but if we are there, I think we can play for the medals for sure.
Okay, you're going for the medals.
Yes, for sure.
And we are going to hockey player Marloes Ketels. Marloes, before we start the interview, we found this video of you training on Instagram. So, Marloes, did you have a career switch? Marloes? Marloes, can you hear me?
I do not hear anything. I don't know if you hear
okay.
me.
Now I hear you. I hope you hear me too. Did you have a career switch? Because we just saw you practicing something else than hockey in the film.
I do not hear the questions. But okay. I can answer on the video maybe if you guys hear me.
Yes.
This was at Papendal, the National Sports Center, and we had strength training, but yeah, you have to do that every week, so sometimes we just, we want to try something else, so I filmed two of my teammates, and we tried to look like gymnastics, but I think they will laugh at it, because with playing hockey, you don't really get flexible. More the opposite, so yeah, we had a lot of fun, but what we do on the field.
Okay, so this is something else than you do on the field, of course. And Marloes, you have played many great matches. In March, you even reached your 150th cap. So how much the Olympics mean to you?
It's the greatest sport event in the world. So it means a lot. The last time we lost, we got silver, so best 5 years, the only thing we thought about was we want to win gold in Tokyo. So we're training really hard for it, and we're looking forward to, it's just the Olympics, it's just something different than a World Cup.
Yeah.
It's just all the best athletes from the whole world come together, and I'm just really looking forward.
I can imagine that. And if we look back for a moment in the run-up to Rio 5 years ago, you told us that you sometimes felt very tense, like you spent a whole year thinking, am I doing well enough? Do you still feel this way, or how do you feel about it right now?
I think the tension just changed. Back in Rio, I was 23. So I really had to get my place in the team. So I was really busy with making the selection. And if I play well now, I'm sure of the Olympic selection, but I still have to reach my level. So there's another tension. And I think I'm more tense about how it's going with the team. So when you get older, you get more responsibilities. So I think I still have a lot of tension, but it's just in different areas.
Okay. But what was it like to train with your team in times of corona? I mean, has the team spirit affected by corona?
If I have any time for my study, I wanted to finish my study after the Olympics, so this year. But then the Olympics got cancelled, but I did start with my last course for my master. and I will hand in my thesis tomorrow. So perfect timing,
yes.
I think.
That's a good.
But I did study a little bit.
Okay, that's good to know. And you have some time left to prepare for the Olympics. So how will the upcoming weeks look like for you and your team?
The upcoming weeks, we still have a European Championship. So it's a busy program. I just finished my club playoffs for the national title, and I think in 2 weeks we have the European Championship, so lots of training, lots of staying in hotels, a lot of testing.
Thank you,
busy
Marie.
Schedule before we go to Tokyo.
Okay, thank you. And I wish you good luck, Marloes. And you, Iris, what are you going to focus in the upcoming period?
Next week we are all together with the team again, and we're going to train full time in our training center, and we're just going to focus on our conditioning and being ready for the opponents we are playing in the Olympics.
Also full weeks ahead.
Yes, full time.
I look forward to watching you both on TV, so good luck with the preparation, and thank you for joining us today.
Thank you.
And now more and more is allowed. We must not forget to keep wearing the face mask. Therefore, here's a little reminder.
All right, everybody, museum's going COVID compliant. Need you wear a mask at all times. Scream, can you watch this bit this week? Here you Van Gogh. Guys, what's going on? Come on, there's no indoor dining. We need this Last Supper moved outdoors. Come on, let's get out of here. Let's move. Hey, Judas, I'm watching you.
Thank you all for watching, and don't forget to watch the last episode of EMTV this academic year. That's Thursday next week, 9 a.m. And if you want to keep update with the latest news, go to erasmusmagazine.nl.